Hello everyone, welcome to your partner in education, Agile Rank Mate. In this particular segment, we're going to be looking at how to prepare for the KEEM exam, which is Kerala Engineering Architecture Medical Exam. Now, this is a very important exam if you want to enter into a job. So therefore, it is quite difficult for some, and therefore we're here to fast track your way into this exam. So today, what we're going to do is we're going to be looking at some questions asked in previous episodes, previous editions of this exam, and then try to solve them for you so that you can get a feel of how the exam is going to look like. So for this particular set of videos, we're going to be looking at each subject and each chapter in detail. So to start things off, we're going to be looking at chemistry and the first, you know, concept which deals with basic concepts of chemistry as well as atomic structure. So let's kick things off with a beautiful question. The question states, the correct set of quantum numbers for a 4D electron. So we have 4, 3, 2 plus half, 4, 2, 1, 0, 4, 3 minus 2 plus half, 4, 2, 1 minus half, 4, 2 minus 2, 0. So how are we going to solve this question? Well, in order to solve the question, we need to understand what the question is talking about. Here we're asked to find out the correct set of quantum numbers. So what are quantum numbers? So quantum numbers are what we call numbers assigned to an electron with respect to its shell, orbital, and spin. So if you've studied atomic structure, you know that electrons are the earlier structure, earlier atomic structure divided electrons to be placed in shells. So each shell has a subshell. Each subshell had one too many orbitals, and each orbital can support two electrons with opposite spin. So there are basically four sets of quantum numbers. We have the principal quantum number, which is represented by N. There is the azimuthal quantum number, which is represented by L. We also have the orbital quantum number. This one's represented by M. And then the spin quantum number, which is represented by S. So how do we figure out the quantum numbers for an electron? Now remember, our question pertains to an electron in the 4D shell, subshell. So 4 represents the shell of that electron. So it means that the electron is present in the fourth shell. Now this 4 is the principal quantum number. So therefore the first quantum number would be 4. How do we calculate the azimuthal quantum number? Now if you've studied atomic structure, you also studied that shells have various subshells. And according to the current periodic table, we currently have 4 types of subshells. We have specific, diffuse, fundamental, and P. So these are the 4 types of subshells. For the subshell S, the azimuthal quantum number assigned would be 0. For P, it would be 1. For D, it would be 2. And for F, it would be 3. So since we're dealing with a 4D electron, the azimuthal quantum number would be 2. Now, before we calculate the orbital and spin quantum numbers, let's look at our options. Now, as you can see, every option has the first quantum number as 4. so we cannot, you know, discard any option. However, if we look at the azimuthal quantum number, we see that options A and C have the number 3 in their quantum numbers. So we have 3 in option A, which shows that the shell subshell is F, which is incorrect. Again, for option C, it's the same case. The other options, B, D, and E, have the number 2 as the azimuthal quantum number, which is correct because we have a 4D electron. Now, how do we calculate the orbital quantum number? Now, the orbital quantum number is quite tricky. It can be present in a range. The range is between minus L to plus L. So for our current scenario, if our azimuthal quantum number is 2, we can have orbital quantum numbers of minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, and 2. So any of these numbers can be the orbital quantum number. Now, this is because for a D subshell, we have 5 orbitals, and therefore it can be represented by any of these numbers. So therefore we have, now if we look at the options given, you can see that option B has 1, option D has 1, and option E has minus 2. So again, you cannot differentiate using the orbital quantum number. Now, what about the spin quantum number? According to Pauli's exclusion principle, no electron will have all 4 quantum numbers as the same in an atom. The reason for this is that in every orbital, you have 2 electrons with opposite spin. So one has a positive spin and the other has a negative spin. The one with the positive spin is assigned plus half as its spin quantum number, and the one with the negative spin would be assigned minus half as its spin quantum number. So therefore, we only have to look at option D here because it's the only one with the correct spin quantum number. So therefore, the correct option among the 5 is option D. Its principal quantum number is 4, the azimuthal quantum number is 2, 1 is its orbital quantum number, which is between the range of minus 2 and 2, and it has a negative spin, so it's minus half. So therefore, 4, 2, 1, and minus half represents the correct set of quantum numbers for a 4D electron among the following options. Now, in this question, we use the method of elimination. By eliminating the answers that do not contain a particular criteria, we can easily reach our correct answer. So, let's look at another question. Which one of the following contains the largest number of molecules? We have 8 grams of methane, 16,800 centimeter cubes of carbon dioxide, 14 grams of nitrogen, 4 grams of oxygen, 64 grams of sulfur dioxide. So, how do we solve this question? For this question, we will use what was called the mole concept. So, what is this mole concept? So in order to count the number of molecules or atoms or formula units in chemistry, we have a quantity called the mole. The mole is, you know, something like what we use in daily life. So for example, for 12 of something, we use a dozen. For 144 of something, we use gross. So similarly, we use the term mole to refer to 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 of something, whether it's atoms, molecules, or formula units. And the mole is easy to calculate. You can calculate it from mass, you can calculate it from volume, you can also calculate it from number of molecules. So in this question, although it's asking us to find the largest number of molecules, it would be enough to find out which of these has the largest number of moles, because the one with the largest number of moles would have more molecules. So let's look at each of the options here. Option 1, 8 grams of methane. Now, methane has the chemical formula CH4. So here we have the mass, the given mass of CH4. In order to find the mole, number of moles, we need to find its molar mass. So its molar mass would be C has a mass of 12 carbon, usually, and H has a mass of 1. And since we have 4 atoms of H, we add 4. So we get 16. So 8 grams of methane would have its number of moles as 8 divided by 16, which is 0.5. So 8 grams of methane would have 0.5 moles of methane. What about option B, 16,800 centimeter cubes of carbon dioxide at STP? Now, the unit centimeter cube is the same as milliliters, and we know that we can calculate the number of moles from volume as well. So how do we calculate that? So 1 mole of any what we say element or compound would have a volume of 22,400 milliliters or centimeter cube. So what we're essentially doing is dividing the given volume by 22,400. So we can cut off the two zeros. 168 and 224 can be divided by 56. So we get 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 moles of carbon dioxide are present, which is equal to 0.75 moles. So 0.75 moles is the number of molecules present in option B. What about option C? 14 grams of nitrogen. Now here it says nitrogen, not nitrogen atom. So therefore, we use the molecule of nitrogen that is N2, the gas. So one nitrogen atom has a mass of 14 U, so therefore the molecular mass of nitrogen would be 14 plus 14, which is equal to 28. So the number of moles in this case would also be 0.5 moles, because 14 divided by 28 would give you 0.5. What about option D, 4 grams of oxygen? Now, if we look at 4 grams of oxygen again, it's O2. So one oxygen atom has it, it 1 mole of oxygen atom weighs 16 grams. So 1 mole of oxygen molecules would weigh 32 grams. So the number of moles here would be 4 divided by 32, which is 1 divided by 8, which is 0.125. So the answer for option, so the number of molecules for option D is 0.125 moles. Now, finally, let's look at option E, 64 grams of sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide's formula is SO2. Sulfur has a mass of 32. O2 again has a mass of 32. 32 plus 32 gives us 64. Since we have 64 grams of sulfur dioxide, when we divide that by its molar mass, which is 64, you get 1 mole. So the correct answer for this question is option E, 64 grams of sulfur dioxide. Now, in this question, we would need to calculate the values for all of the options. The reason being that we need to convert all of these options to number of molecules, or for easier method, number of moles. And since we use moles, we can simplify our calculations, because the value with the highest number of moles would give us the largest number of molecules. So option E would be the correct option. That concludes this episode of Cream Crash Course. Now, we at Agile RankMate focus on providing carefully curated content. So we would like you to use our content.